Yeah, this really is an unprecedented situation. Attorneys say that they hope this mea culpa, this apology, can have a profound impact on the entire justice system.
They were in the cage, and it's two guards that are accused of treating them like animals. These so-called fight nights went on for months, but this week will bring a reckoning and reconciliation.
It's rarely done. So to create what I'm going to call a precedent means that there might be a model that we can create from this for other cases.
Attorneys David Malik and Thomas Perani represented four teenagers who they say during their time at the Cuyahoga County Juvenile Detention Center were subjected to Fight Club style bouts. Two guards who have since resigned either orchestrated and forced the fights or stood idly by as teenagers took turns pummeling one another every Friday night over 3 months in 2016. Cuyahoga County approved a nearly $180,000 settlement, but with one big caveat.
Every tort lawyer knows that money doesn't heal past wrongs. It's not going to psychologically help these kids from sleeping well at night. A lot of them have nightmares. A lot of them have PTSD.
Nobody is legally admitting fault. But what they are doing is saying, whatever happened here, we're sorry that it happened under our watch. And we want you to know we're sorry.
At an unprecedented reconciliation hearing, a representative of juvenile court will personally apologize to the plaintiffs on behalf of the court without legally admitting fault. The teenagers will also be afforded the opportunity to tell the court how the alleged reprehensible acts of the two guards has impacted their life. But these veteran attorneys hope those two little words, "we're sorry," will have a profound impact.
We came up with this idea because there's a trend in the legal field now towards what they call restorative justice.
Restorative justice will be a healing mechanism, hopefully, that will help these kids to get back on the right track because they're young enough that their lives can be turned around, and that's our hope.
They were in the cage, and two guards are accused of treating them like animals. But Malik hopes that not only will this hearing make his clients feel human again, but also that the entire system adopts this more personable approach.
I think for anybody that has a whole brain, there shouldn't be any resistance in buying into this model.
Attorneys say the final details of this reconciliation hearing are still being worked out, but it is expected to take place sometime this week. Reporting live on the East Side, George Berg, News 5.